So, what is quantum? Quantum is a blockchain that uses what they call the incentive proof of stake. What is quantum? It's a compatible ecosystem that utilizes things like Oracle and data feeds in conjunction with logic of regulations to bridge reward in the blockchain world. So you see a lot of blockchain applications that are being created today. Many of them do not put into consideration regulations and all that. Now, quantum introduces Oracle's data feeds and identity model from third parties to fulfill compliance requirements from traditional internet enterprises, including finance, IoT. So the main core of blockchain is, well, Ethereum is very good. Bitcoin is very good. Why not we combine some of the features and then create something that is very, very okay? So why Ethereum has something they call smart contracts? Quantum is considering the world. How do we bring in on-chain and off-chain factors? How do we bring them together and put them into consideration to make a better smart contract? How do we create contracts that not only do we say, okay, this contract, how do we create contracts that are dynamic, that this they can respond to immediate changes? Like, okay, the temperature in a room, it fluctuates, this. How do we execute that automatically? Make things smart contracts are very good, but how do we create master contract that takes into consideration real world applications, real world laws and all that? And then Quantum uses the mobile go strategy. So Quantum is seeking to create mobile decentralized applications, have a mobile decentralized app store and all that. So if you we want to create the blockchain and make the blockchain usable to a lot of persons, we don't have to run blockchains that first. I think there are two things that are going to make this stuff very, very useful to people. The first thing is it has to be something that can be accessed from nearly every medium, like mobile phones. And then the blockchain again has to be something that's supposed to be accessed except from platforms like the web. So though if let's go to CoinMarketCap, you see a lot of applications, this, but how many of them are being used on a daily basis? The few of them that are being used on a daily basis are things like Brave Browser and then Steemit, and the list is few of many platforms that have been used. Most of them are just like this kind of speculative tool of investment and all that. So Quantum is seeking to create kind of blockchain that can run on top of mobile stuffs. So it's an hybrid blockchain system. So what does that mean? They combine the features of Bitcoin, then they combine some of the features of Ethereum. So you'll be asking, how do you now combine that? Because you're something like Bitcoin, for example, uses the unspent transaction outputs, and then the Ethereum uses something like the accounts state model. So what basically happens is that at the top of it, you have the Ethereum network, and then in between the Bitcoin and then the Ethereum network is what we have something called the abstraction layer. So the abstraction layer is the point where there's a translation of maybe how things work in a different environment. So let's take, for example, you are translating from A to B. So there has to be an abstraction layer that defines and translates the different interpretations that happens within the system. So if you see some of the comments that have been made by some of the creators of Ethereum, like Anthony D. Aihoro, I don't know how to pronounce this, but you can see from the screen. And then Bunsheng, the managing director of managing partner at Fembushi Capital, and then Roger Verdeau is the kind of controversial person in this space. You many of them have some cool features about that, and many people have been likening Quantum to Mu or Ethereum and all that. I don't really think so, but they really have a very, very good modem. You see, this is the main, why not we combine what has been existing before with what has not been existing, create something that is more better. That is one of the major thing of quantum. And they have something very, very good. And it's very, very compatible with a lot of systems. So you want to go through that white paper, you want to reach to them and see all the platforms that are being built on them, where they are today, who is behind their team. Let's see their team. The members and all that. So you can see some of the ideas that have been built on the quantum system. Okay, so that is enough for now. Do have a very good day.